everyone. Good evening, good morning, good afternoon. We've got people from Asia and Africa and America, and we are excited to see all of you. My name is Cheryl, and I am part of the Global 1 for 50 leadership team, but it's my pleasure to be your host on the call today. We are going to be doing something very exciting today. And for the next few calls, we are going to be showcasing some of 1 for 50's other curriculum. Many of you are familiar with the 12 curriculum, but we have many other curricula available. And every 2 weeks for the next 2 months, we are going to be showcasing or presenting a different lesson from one of the curriculum that 1 for 50 has developed that you can use in your own training. And so today's topic is going to be on memory verses. And I'm sure many of you are on the call because you want to get ideas for teaching memory verses to children. And that's one of our 1 for 50 enrichments. But as we look ahead, there's a lot of other great lessons coming. On the 25th of October, we will be doing a lesson on communicating with children. On the 8th of November, we will be talking about object lessons and demonstrations, how to teach those to children. The 15th of November, we are going to talk about handling the outside influences that are impacting our children. And on the last one, on November 29th, we are going to be talking about children and trauma. So write those dates down, get ready. We'll remind you at the end of the call as well. I'm going to call on Daniel now, if Daniel is here, and he's going to introduce our speaker for today.
Thank you very much. My name is Daniel, and I come from Kenya, and I'm passionate about children. Today, we have a very special facilitator for us. Her name is Kimberly, and Kimberly comes from the USA. She's passionate also about children, and she will be taking us through the course. I therefore invite all of you to check on your notes to follow up, but she will be ready presenting to us, so be keen and follow up the lessons. In case you have any questions, then you can spare and write them down on the chat, and then we will answer them at the end of the call. Welcome everybody, and let's put our hands together as we welcome teacher Kimberly Holley from USA.
Oh, thank you so much, Daniel. What a joy it is to have each of you on the call today. As we begin our call today, make sure that as you have your name listed there on our Zoom call, you also put where you're from. It's exciting to know where all the different places that people are serving in and they're logging in this morning. So take a moment and rename yourself and let us know where you're coming from. As we begin our call today, I have a quick question for you. I'm curious, as we talk about memory verses today, what is the very first Bible verse that you ever memorized? The very first one. Take a moment and write that down in the chat. Let's see all the different verses that we've learned, our very first ones actually together. Genesis 1:1, Cheryl says. Milton says John 3:16. John 3:16, Daniel says. Romans 6:23, Gladys. Oh, Ruth says John 3:16, that's a popular one. Oh, Nellie says the same, yep. And isn't it exciting to see those first memory verses are still tucked away inside our heart pocket? Martha said Mark 9:23. Psalm 23 says Mike from Nigeria. Another John 3:16. Oh, it's so exciting to see all these Bible verses that we've tucked away inside of our heart pockets today. This is going to be a great lesson, you guys. This lesson is actually one of the 15 different lessons that we call 1 for 50 enrichments. These enrichments explore more deeply some of the key topics taught in the 12 curriculum. Unlike other 1 for 50 training modules, each 1 for 50 enrichment lesson is written to stand alone, making it easy to use as a supplement to the other training materials. Today's lesson on memory verse ideas is one of several lessons about making disciples. If you remember your 1 for 50 hand, our pointer finger is all about making disciples. The other enrichment lessons for this part of the 1 for 50 hand include managing classroom behavior, and that was demonstrated earlier in the year, object lessons and demonstrations, preparing a Bible story, drama experiences, and classroom games. You can find the whole list of enrichment lessons on the document that's going to be shared in the chat. And Jenny will be sharing those towards the end of the call today. I'm going to show you, now as we begin today, I'm going to show you a slide with some objects on it. I'm only going to show you the slide for 20 seconds. Yes, you heard me correctly. Only 20 seconds, and you must memorize all 12 of the objects. You can't write them down, okay? So 20 seconds, a slide with 12 objects. You have to memorize them, can't write them down. Go. That 20 seconds went awfully quick, didn't it? All right, now in the chat, I would like for you to write your name if you think you can name all 12 of the objects. Just raise your hand or maybe write your name in the chat and we'll call on you and we'll hear if you have them all. Daniel, go for it.
I think that's all people. Apple, car, balloon, torch, tree, a heart of grass. Yeah, that's what I saw.
Pretty good. That's what you saw. Okay, who else could maybe raise their hand or put their name in the chat and could contribute to Daniel's list? Something Daniel did not say. I know it was only 20 seconds.
Mike from Nigeria.
Mike, go ahead.
Balloon, ball, touchlights, car. Oh.
Okay, that's pretty good. Anyone else? We've got some things in the chat. Apple and hippo, yes. Oh, Remy.
Okay, I saw a Christmas tree apart from the things that had been mentioned already.
Thank you, Remy. That's great. Martha, my friend from Malawi, you have your hand up. What else did you see that wasn't mentioned?
Yes, I saw a table. I saw a balloon. A cat, and a Bible.
Very good. Well, you guys did a tremendous job. Thank you so much. I know it would have been easier if we would have given you more than 20 seconds, and it would have been easier if we could have written them all down. But my question is, was it easier to remember the objects by yourself or with a group? If you think with a group, just put in your hand, just put in the chat group. I think we would definitely all agree that it was so much easier to do it as a group than to do it individually. Because as a group, we were able to come up with things that others might have missed, absolutely as a group. Remember, things are always easier with help. This is also true when it comes to remembering God's word. We're going to look at a Bible verse from John 14, 25 through 26. And I was asking Gloria to help, but she's having a thunderstorm right now. So I'm going to call on Martha. Martha, could you read our Bible verse that's on the screen right there? John 14, 25 through 26 for us.
John 14, verse 25 to 26. All this I have spoken while still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you.
Oh, amen. Thank you, Sister Martha. So who is it that helps us remember the things that Jesus taught? It's the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one who helps us to remember the things we've studied and learned in Scripture. He is also the one who helps our children to remember the scriptures, reminding them of what they have learned and what they have heard. We can also play a role in helping children hide God's word in their hearts. We can do this by making Bible verse memory fun and exciting. In this lesson, we'll be learning new ideas and games for helping children learn memory verses. Our lesson today is going to be a triad activity. We're going to do idea exchange. We'll do a practicum, and then we'll have a little bit of reflection and prayer. The one for 50 hand, don't forget, this is super important. This is number one, making disciples. Oh, very good, guys. So to get our creative juices flowing, I'm going to teach you several memory verse games. But I'm not simply going to tell you what they are. We are going to play them together. Oh, it's going to be fun. As if you were children in my classroom. In the 12 curriculum, this is the lesson on helping children engage with God's word. We learned that memorizing scripture is more than just being able to repeat a memory verse. This is a process to move the verse from the child's head to their heart to their life. And let's not forget, and we want to present so that they can memorize it, so the child can learn what it says. We want to discuss so the child understands what it means. And of course, we want to apply so that the child learns what it means to them. Oh, great. I have a memory verse that I want you to take a look at. It's gonna be up on your screen. It's a short memory verse. Most of us have probably memorized this already, but we're gonna take a moment today and we're gonna use this verse as we play our memory verse games. Now, just a little bit of explanation about this memory verse. When you're working with children, it's important for them to understand the words in the verse, to know where to find the verse. And sometimes people will call the Bible reference the Bible address, because we all have to know the location of where we live at. So sometimes people change the Bible reference to the Bible address, just so that it's a little easier for children to understand. Now you'll see the Bible address, the Bible reference is right there in front of us, Romans. Now, if I'm working with children, I would say, is this in the Old Testament or the New Testament? Our Bible is divided in half with two parts, old and new. If you think that this verse, this book of the Bible, Romans, is in the New Testament, would you just raise your hand? Just raise your hand in the chat so I can see how many of you know where to find this book of Romans in the Bible. Oh, I see those raising of hands. Yes, that's right. Give me a clap. Give me a raise. Give me a thumbs up. You guys are so smart. Absolutely. Romans is in the New Testament. And then if I'm working with children also, I might need to explain those numbers. What are those numbers all about? Well, the number 3 is the chapter number. And the other number after that, 23, is the verse number. So after I've explained where to find it, I'm also going to explain some of those words that are in the verse. And, you know, you might think they're so simple, Kimberly. Do we really need to explain them? And my answer is absolutely. Making it clear, easy, and understandable for children to apply to their heart and to their life is our goal. So the word all. You know, all seems like it would be pretty simple, but if we take a look at it, we can even make it easier for children to understand. So I just say, all means everyone. It means you. It means me. It means our moms and dads, our pastors, our Sunday school teachers, our presidents, and our prime ministers. All means everyone. And then if you look at the next word we might need to explain, sinned. Oh, for all have sinned. Now, when you think about the word sin, that is something that needs to be explained to a child. What is sin? The Bible tells us just right here that every one of us have done it. So I like to keep it very simple for children. Sin is something that you think, you say, you do, or you don't do that displeases God. That's what sin is. All of us have done it. And of course, there's some other parts of this verse. Fall short. fall short, does that mean that maybe our grades fall short? Does that mean maybe our chores or activities fall short? No, it means because we've all sinned, we've fallen short of God's perfect standard of excellence, his perfect standard of righteousness. Now I've presented where to find it. I've explained the words so that can be understood, but now I want to apply it. Now when I'm applying a memory verse, I want to remember that as I apply it, there's two groups of students that I need to consider as I apply this verse. The first is to a child that is already walking with the Lord. It's a saved child. And so as I apply this verse to the saved child, I might say something like, if you've already received Christ's forgiveness for your sins, will you thank him now? And maybe offer them an opportunity to pray. Or I might say something like, if you've already received Christ's forgiveness for your sins, will you go and tell someone else? But then there's also another group of students I need to consider as I'm working with them in my classroom. And those are the children that are unsaved, that are not born again. Now, for them, this application is going to be different than the saved child. For them, I might say, if you have not received Christ to forgive your sins, would you do that today? Would you come and talk to me at the end of our class and I can show you from God's word how you can do that? Now you see how those two applications are different, but you can see they're both so important for both of those groups. So now that we have presented it, now that we have understood all the different parts and the words and that we've applied it, now we're going to practice it. So while you keep yourself muted, we're just going to say the verse together, okay? We're going to do it on three. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Good. Now, you guys did a super job, but don't forget to keep yourself muted, okay? You guys are also excellent at this. We're going to practice it again, okay? Here we go. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Romans 3:23.
Okay, good job, everybody. You're doing so good. You're working so hard. Just keep yourself muted so we don't have any distractions. You can say it where you are, and that is wonderful. So now that we have practiced the verse two times, I think many of us are ready to maybe try a little game. So we're going to do that right now. So to help us remember the verse, we're actually going to play a game called Freeze. Okay, Freeze. That's right. You heard me. So I'm going to say one, two, three, freeze. And when I say the word freeze, you need to choose a silly pose and stay in that pose while you say the memory verse. Okay? All right, I can't wait to see your silly pose. Here we go. One, two, three, freeze. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Good job, everybody. Now keep yourself muted. Maybe Jenny, you could help us out with that. All right. Well, you did great. We're going to find another silly pose. Okay. So here we go. One, two, three, freeze. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Oh, you guys did super. Okay. Now let's do another one. All right. Are you ready for another one? Let's try it together. One, two, three, freeze. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Oh, you guys are super. Wow. You're pros at this. I can tell you're getting the hang of it. Those silly faces are amazing. Okay. Now we're going to try a little bit of a different game. And this game is so exciting. I love it. It's called Different Voices. We're going to say the memory verse several times. And each time we do it, we're going to use a different voice. The first time we're saying it, we're going to use a really high voice. So you got to get your voice up there. You got to get it really, really high. Okay, super high, like a really, really high pitch voice. I think we understand. Are you ready? Now it's going to be on three again, okay? Keep yourself muted. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. You guys are so awesome at this. Wow. Okay, so we went high. Now we're going to go low. We're going to go really low. So this time, pull out your really low voice, and we're going to try it one more time. Are you ready? Let's try it on three. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Oh, wow. Boy, that took a lot to go that low, didn't it? Ooh. All right. Well, now we're going to go not only we went low, but now we're going to go slow, really slow. Okay. So we're going to slow it up. All right. Here we go. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Wow, you guys were super slow motion on that one. Excellent job. Wow, I am impressed. You guys are doing a great job. Okay, so we went high. We went low. We went slow. Now we're going to go really fast. Are you ready to go really fast? Okay, let's go really, really, really fast. And we're going to go on three. Are you ready? One, two, three. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Romans 3:23.
You guys did great. Let's try that one again. It happened so fast, I think I missed it. So let's try it again, really fast, on three. One, two, three. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Whoa, you guys did great. That was awesome. Okay, so we did silly faces. We did different voices. Now we're gonna do something called the color call. The color call. So I will call out a color. And if you're wearing that color, you must stand up and say our Bible verse, okay? I know a lot of you are sitting down. I know you're resting comfortably in your chair, but we're gonna get you up. Are you ready to get up? Here we go. I'm looking for the color blue. If you're wearing the color blue, stand up and say our verse. Okay, I see a few. Oh, I see a few. Here we go. All right. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Good job, everyone wearing blue. Okay, now, if you're wearing the color white, I want you to stand up and say our verse on three. I'm wearing white, so I'm going to stand up. Here we go. Romans 3:23. I got excited. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Whoa, good job, everybody. Okay, how about this color? What about the color black? If you're wearing black, all the people wearing black today, stand up and say our verse. All right, here we go on three. One, two, three. Romans 3:23. for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Whoa, super job, everybody wearing black. Amazing. Well, you know, where I am right now, it's pretty early in the morning. And a lot of people early in the morning, they like to do their exercises. So we're actually going to do something right now. We're going to exercise with God's word. Exercising with God's word. Did you ever think of something so amazing? Well, we're going to do that. So what I need you to do is you can stand up. Yes, stand up. And I'm going to have you do an exercise. And when we're doing that exercise on three, I'm going to have us do the memory verse. Okay, so I'm going to stand up. All right, but I don't want to go too far where you can't see me. So we're going to stand up and we're going to exercise first by doing arm circles. Put your arms out and let's do some arm circles. All right, great job. On three, we're going to say our memory verse. 1, 2, 3. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Oh, good job. You guys did great. Okay, sit back down. Now I have an exercise that you can do while sitting for some of you guys. We're going to do our shoulder rolls. Just do your shoulder rolls. You can do them backwards. You can do them forwards. Just do your shoulder rolls. Do your shoulder rolls. Oh, super job. Now we're going to say our memory verse on three. 1, 2, 3. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Good job, everybody. Now, whether you're sitting or standing, you can do the next one. Let's kind of work our necks out a little bit. Get those kinks out. Oh, get those kinks out of our neck and the knots. On three, our memory verse, guys. 1, 2, 3. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Wow. We're working up a sweat, aren't we? How many calories are we burning? I can't even imagine. Now we're going to do our finger exercises. Yep. Get your fingers going. Now, if you're a beginner to the finger exercise, you can do one. If you're a professional, you can do five. Here we go. You beginners, are you professionals? Here you go. 1, 2, 3. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Are we having fun yet? I know we are. Are you learning the verses? Absolutely. If we as adults are having fun learning God's word, don't you think the children will too? The games we just played are just a few of the many examples of creative ways to teach a Bible verse to children. I'm sure that each of you have your own ideas as well. So I would like to give you the opportunity to share your ideas with each other. You're going to go into breakout rooms. There'll be five of you for 5 minutes, five for 5 minutes. In your group, you're going to have each person share one of their favorite memory verse games. If your audio is kind of weak and your internet is unstable, you can just write your favorite game in the chat in your group. Be sure you have a spokesperson so that when you come back in, we can hear about all your great ideas in the main session. After everyone has shared at least one idea, then you can go back around and share additional ideas. Okay, are you guys ready? You're going to get ready to go to your breakout rooms. All right, we'll see you back here in 5 minutes. Good job. Okay, so what I'd like for you to do, if you were the spokesman for your group, if you could put your name in the chat, and then I'll call on you, and if you could share the ideas that you talked about in your breakout group, we're actually going to put them on the whiteboard so that everybody can see the ideas that you talked about in your group. So if you were the spokesperson, just put your name in the chat so I can call on you, and you can share your ideas with us. All right, Savior, we're going to let you go first. So, Savior, why don't you share your memory verse ideas?
All right. So we had using their favorite food. So you ask them, how many of you love eating rice? And when they raise their hands, you ask them to say the memory verse. Another option is you write the full memory verse on the board, and you clean sections of it, and you ask them to read it on the board whilst they are filling in the blank spaces. And also, Alphonse shared with us, they use songs to teach the memory verse. So these are the three. We had only three active members in our team. So these are the three activities we used.
Thank you. Oh, Savior, thank you so much. All right, Daniel, I saw your name pop up there. Let's hear from your group.
Yeah, in my group, we had several. We say that you can toss a ball. That is one of them. And when the ball falls down, the whole class repeats the song. If the ball you toss randomly is caught up by a student, that student repeats the verse. Then we have singing the verse. And then we have using pictures. You can arrange pictures to represent the verse. And then you pull away the pictures one at a time to help the children repeat the verse. Then we have chanting, like whereby somebody reads like in a military parade. Oh, it recites a line and the rest. They just chant after you the verse until they get several times. So those were some of the ideas we came up with in our group.
Thank you, Daniel. Okay, Milton, let's hear from you.
All right, thank you, Kimberly. Our group, we had about six ideas. The first thing was memory verse puzzle. We take a memory verse that has been printed and you mix up the words and you want them to make a puzzle out. And alongside that, we can also even do a competition, put them in separate groups. They each have their set of words and they quickly build it up. We also talked about stepping stones as a method where you put some stones, bricks, especially for us in Africa here, you are able to pretend like you are crossing a river. So on the other side of the river, you say the memory verse, and then the stones represent every phrase or every word. And then when you get to the other side, you also say the memory verse. We also spoke about memory verse volley. You can use a ball or you can use a balloon. And every time that somebody hits the balloon or the ball up, the whole group says the words. They do that. The last two were rhythm, getting the words and putting them into a rhythm or making a song out of the words of the memory verse. So those were the points that we came up with.
Oh, thank you so much, Milton. All right, Tandon. I hope I said that correctly. You could unmute and share your ideas.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes, please share with us.
Okay. All right, thank you. In addition to some that have been written on the board, which we also mentioned in my group, we said action. That's the one that I've not seen on the board right now. You turn the verse into action. You use action to verbalize or visualize the memory verse. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. Okay. Let's try my sister from Nigeria, Ebun.
Yeah. I want to add to what has been listed. Even though in my group nobody talked, I don't know. Maybe they had an issue with their phone. We can pass some baskets from one person to another. So once the basket gets to you, you will say your memory verse. We can ask, have you eaten today? Those who have not eaten, they can say their memory verse, or those who have eaten, they can say their memory verse. Then we can fill in the gap. There can be a gap fill. So we will just say, for God so loved, dash. Then you can fill in the gap. Then you can say, close your eyes and say the memory verse, or clap and say the memory verse. We can dramatize it, you know, action. That's it. God bless you.
Wow. Oh, these are so good, you guys. excellent job. Your groups were working so hard. I'm so proud of each of you guys. Great job. Look at this incredible list that was created. You know, the ideas for making memory verse learning fun are absolutely endless as our imagination. And the more excited we are about teaching God's word, the more excited our children will be to learn it. A little later on, before we conclude the call, so don't get off the call until you make sure you've received this, Jenny's going to put in the chat a link, some memory verse game ideas. And you'll want to make sure to have that as a resource. You know, now that we have so many ideas, it is time for us to practice. You're going to go back to your breakout room groups to practice. I'm going to give you the memory verse of Genesis 1:1. So you're going to have 5 minutes to come up with three different ways to teach that verse. So you're going to have 5 minutes to come up with three different ways to teach Genesis 1:1. So I hope everyone understands. Get ready to go to your breakout room. Prabhu will be sending you, and we'll welcome you back in 5 minutes. All right. Well, welcome back, everyone. We hope you came up with some good games to teach memory verses in your group. While learning God's word can be fun and made into games, we don't want to lose sight of why knowing God's word is so important. And I've asked Mike from Nigeria if he wouldn't mind reading Psalm 19:7-11 for us.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. Psalm 19:7-11. The decree of the Lord are firm, and all of them are righteous. They are more precious than gold, than much pure gold. They are sweeter than honey from the honeycomb. By them, your servant is warned. In keeping them, there is great reward.
Oh, thank you so much. Amen and amen. Amen. God's word is a treasure. Is a treasure that can really change our lives. I remember there was a time when I was working in the underground in China, and we were going out for a training, and we were going under the cover of darkness, and we were going out to a faraway location, and we were traveling in the middle of the night. Christians in China endure a lot of persecution. And as we were traveling out to this place, we were praying and we were trusting the Lord for everything that he had in store for us. And I remember that when we came to the location where our host was going to meet us, it was in the middle of a field. It was well after midnight. It was so dark. And I remember seeing a flashlight, a torch, and it was coming, just bouncing up and down through the field. And it got closer and closer and closer to us. And then all of a sudden, the torch got right to where we were sitting in the car. And the door opened, and there I saw the most wonderful face. It was the face of my host, a person that I knew well. We embraced one another, and then he motioned for me to come with him. And as I came with him, that torch, it kind of just went before us. And I remembered God's word at that moment, where it says, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." And I thought, that is exactly what God's word is for us. It gives us the next step that we need to take in our life. So I pray that God's word today for you would be so real, that it would light your path, that would give you the next step that you need to take, that it would lead you, that it would guide you in every area and every decision that you need to make today. So as we close our time together, I would like for each of you just to take a moment to reflect on these questions. When did God use scripture verse, maybe use a scripture verse that you had memorized to encourage your heart or to guide you in a situation? You know, think about that for a moment. you know, when did God use that memory verse to encourage your heart, to guide you in a situation?
I remember I had a situation and I was kind of low into my heart. I was like discouraged. And I remember a verse that I memorized when I was on a campus. It is in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13, that says, God is always faithful. Even when we are faithless, he remains faithful because he cannot deny himself. And I was like, what? Even though I'm feeling like faithless, I don't have courage, I don't have faith, I don't know what I'm thinking about, I don't know what I believed, God is still faithful and I need to rely on him till I get through that situation. And I remembered, wow, this is the power of memorizing scriptures. And I got through the situation and I thank God. And till today, that is one of my favorite memory verses. Yeah, thank you.
Oh, Aldafe, thank you so much for sharing that. What an encouragement that is to our hearts. Man, God's word is precious and it changes our life. It is the foundation that we build our life on, a strong foundation that allows us to have confidence in God and in his word. Well, our second question is right there. And it says, what are two or three new memory verse games that you will try with your children? Now, we had so many of those. Wow, there were tons of ideas. And I think from the many ideas that were shared that you can easily choose two or three or possibly even more today. Jenny is going to put all the available links that we talked about today in the chat for you to download. So make sure that you're able to access those. If you have any questions, please let us know. In fact, we're going to take a moment. We're just going to close in a word of prayer. So I'm just going to pray over us today. And again, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for taking the time out of your very busy life, out of your very busy schedule to make this a priority today. May God richly bless you. Let's pray together. Gracious Heavenly Father, we love you so much and we love your word. Your word is eternal. Your word is a treasure. Your word never changes. God, you are faithful. And Lord, we are grateful that we had this opportunity today to look at your word and how to put your word inside of our life and inside of the lives of the children that we work with. We know that your word is active and alive, and it does. It changes hearts. It changes us from the inside out. And so, Lord, I pray today that as we leave this call, we would be well equipped to teach memory verses to children in a fun and exciting way that will put this eternal word inside of each of their life, not just in their head, but in their heart, and that it would transform their life. I pray a blessing for each of my brothers and sisters today, that you would just use them. I pray that you would provide for them, that you would bless them, that you would anoint them, that you would bless the families that they have and the ministries that they share. We love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. And we're just gonna see if there's any questions. Oh, Nellie has a very good question. Best translation version for memory verses, with children. That is an excellent question, Nellie. I actually get that question quite a bit. And, you know, for us in the U.S., we have something called the NIRV, New International Reader's Version. It's a little easier translation for children. So that might be something that you have access to and can use. The other thing is maybe the NIV might be a good translation. The King James can be a little bit more difficult and challenging. The English in there, some of the words are Old English and it's a little bit harder for children. Also keep in mind that if they're younger, maybe a shorter verse, maybe not something so long. So hopefully that helps answer your question. Daniel also put in here, just to keep in mind that the YouTube, the 1 for 50 YouTube channel is also a great resource for parents and for teachers as well.
Thank you very much, everyone. We want to thank Kimberly first for leading us in our session today. That was a good, wonderful presentation, and I'm sure that we have learned so many things. We want to thank Jenny and Pabu for being behind the scenes and leading our tech. Now we just want to talk about the announcements of the things that are upcoming so that we can, you know, make sure that we put a date on the 25th of October. It will be a Tuesday, same time like today. We'll be having another call, Communicating with Children, with Jackie. And we need to book that and, you know, make sure that we've booked a date for us to learn more about communicating with children. On the 8th of November, we'll be having Nancy Fritz, and she will be leading us in a session on object lesson and demonstration so that we'll be able to see how it really works. And then after that, we're going to have on the 15th of November, a session where we're going to be looking at handling outside influences with Cheryl. So we need to make a date. There's one more on the 29th. We're going to have Auntie Debbie Mendred leading us in children and trauma on the 29th. So thank you very much for joining. God bless you so much. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you very much this day for allowing us to learn and refresh on memory verses. We want to pray and thank you for the facilitators and everyone who has managed to join. We pray that we'll be able to get what we have learned today and go and implement it in our various ministries for your glory. We pray that children and youth will come to know your word and be transformed by it and be able to live. We want to thank you for the time that we had. May you bless us as we go in our different ways. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.